Are your eyebrows on fleek?
Yes, totally. You see, I just trimmed them like 3-4 months ago, like just now. How's it going, fellow photophiles? My name is Ilya and welcome to the weekly Wednesday vlog. Now, I got a whole bunch of questions on my videos, on my channel, and across my social media in general, and I wanted just to get to some of them and answer you guys. Some of these are quite complex, some of them are pretty simple, and frankly, some of them are stupid, but I want to answer them all because I appreciate your guys' feedback in any way. So, Lar Family says, I love how much you travel. What is the best place that you've traveled to? Now, in my opinion, I don't actually travel that much. It just so happened that in the last 3 months of summer, I had several trips lined up, so some of my vlogs were like travel vlogs, one after the other, and it seemed that way. This year is the first time I went to Albania. We were in a national park, completely cut off from like society with pretty much no Wi-Fi, and I really loved the feeling of that pure nature, and any way you turn is just beautiful to look. Just Maria D says, people who think making YouTube videos is a simple thing have obviously not watched how you do it. What was your mom's reaction to the music video? So this is referring to a music video I made for my mom's birthday. I wasn't present to see her reaction, but she did say she laughed a bit, she cried a bit, and she really appreciated it overall. South Seas Tease says, nice advice, you speak Russian? Да, я говорю по-русски. Tatiana Newton says, we want a drone for some of our vacation shots. Do you have one you would suggest? Okay, now this is a really extensive subject. Like, there are literally thousands upon thousands of videos on YouTube discussing different drones, their pros and cons, prices, features, etc. And just like with any type of equipment, it's a question of features and quality versus price. DJI is pretty much the leading company in the area right now, so if you're on a really tight budget, you probably go for the DJI Spark, which is under 500 bucks or so. It's full HD, got a bunch of features, not the best quality, but it's passable for like basic YouTube videos. If you have a bigger budget, you'd go with like the Mavic Air or the new Mavic Pro 2 or the Mavic Pro Zoom, I think it's called, the newest ones. They're a lot better. And that's without going into like the really high quality ones where you attach your camera to the drone, like the DJI Inspire 1 or whatever it's called. So recently I heard of another company called Parrot. Apparently they make drones, an alternative to DJI kind of, and some of their features are even better than DJI, so some people actually prefer that over DJI. I don't know, I haven't checked it out. So Absolutely Creative says, hi Ilya, it's always great to get back to your videos, very useful information every video of yours. I would like to know how to get sponsorships for my videos. Yes, this is one of those very complicated ones. I haven't personally got a sponsorship yet. I'm sure it's a case-to-case scenario. Sometimes companies will reach out to you and offer you a sponsorship deal. Sometimes you have to look for it. There are websites where you can connect with sponsors and offer to feature them or advertise them in your video. There are probably groups for that where people collaborate and introduce each other to their previous sponsors or whatever. Since my YouTube content is about video creation, you probably know that I'm a video creator and a filmmaker. So what I have done is offer to make a promotional video or film an event in exchange for something, whether it's equipment or cash or whatever other kind of compensation. But the concept remains the same. If you want a company to sponsor you in some way, they're offering you value, so you have to offer value in return. If that value is simply advertising value as an influencer, you probably have to have at least 10 to 50,000 followers and a very high engagement ratio, so that kind of advertising is something that those sponsors will see value in. And if you think you have got what it takes, then just reach out to those companies, especially online based ones, because then you don't have to worry about which country you're in, and send them the offer or the request that you had in mind. But the point is, you have to reach out. They're not just gonna come and find you. So hey Magda, DIY beauty, hair and jewelry says, hi Ilya, how are you doing my friend? You are doing such a great job. I enjoy all your videos. Thank you. I have a question for you. Between filming and editing, what do you like the most? This is a really complex question that I've actually been asking myself for a while, because I love filming. I don't like sitting at my desk. I like being active. I like being in the field, especially if it's something funner like action sports or extreme sports, or even if it's just an event. I like walking around, meeting people, doing active things. But on the other side of the scale, I really like traveling, and my ultimate goal right now is to kind of move everything I do to an online space, because that way I can, for example, convert a van and just start traveling, and wherever I have internet I can continue working and travel. And editing makes a lot more sense here, because then if I stop filming and if I have a bunch of companies who just send work to edit, that will make my dream come true. I can travel around, I can edit videos, send them back to them, and still be on the road full time. So essentially, if anything ever comes of this
YouTube channel venture, that will be the best because I can continue filming, do a little bit of editing, and still be on the road full time. Ian and Silly's family adventures. Nice footage. Our problem with the GoPro is that it's kind of dark as well. Is this one waterproof? Yes. Yeah, my Xiaomi camera, I don't know where it is right now. I'd have to dig it out. It has a kind of casing like any other GoPro or action camera, and that casing is waterproof to like 60 meters or so. I even filmed an underwater video with it, and it did perfectly fine. The problem with the casing is that it covers the microphone, so then the sound you get is really muted, and you can't really understand what people are saying. Amazing video, quick question. How do you edit the letters so they appear one by one? I'm learning to edit since we opened our channel, but every time I write a text, the whole word appears, not one by one. Thank you. Well, this is a more complicated question. It would require an entire tutorial, and maybe I'll make it in one of the next series. But really quickly, when you create a text and you open the properties in After Effects, there's a little animate button and you click on it and you click opacity. So it means you're animating the opacity. And then if you play around with the start and end settings, then the words or the letters, the sentence appears from the beginning to the end, depending on the percentage. And then in the sub settings, you set instead of a word, you put it to letter. So then literally when you play around with start from the end at 0%, it's nothing. And at end percent, it's 100%. And between, it just removes one letter at a time. That's how I made that effect. I like drone footage so much, mostly when you have a good quality one. Is it hard to manage? The Dope Squad video was my first time flying a proper drone. And I think within about 5 to 10 minutes, I got the good hang of it. Like regular pan shots, lifting shots, push in, push out shots, that was pretty easy to get because literally what you do is get your drone on the proper altitude, set your composition, and just start moving around. But for more complicated shots, like maybe a pan rotation shot where you're trying to track a subject or rotate around something, that's a bit more complicated and would require quite a bit more practice. This is a question from a fellow YouTuber, and she sent it to me on Facebook. She said, hey, what is it better to shoot in 24 frames per second or 30 frames per second? Now, there's no rule about this. It's up to you how and what you want to shoot. What you do need to know is why this or why that. 24 frames per second is the standard in the filmmaking industry. So shooting 24 frames per second and publishing your videos like that makes it appear more cinematic. That's the only reason. That's when you get your motions to look smooth, not too smooth, but not too jittery. It's that frame rate that we're used to in watching movies. 30 frames per second is usually used by gamers. It looks a lot more realistic where everything's moving really fast and smoothly. What you could do, and what I often do with my 60 frames per second, is film things in a higher frame rate, especially B-roll, and then when you bring it in, you can slow it down. So instead of 30 frames per second, you slow it down to 24 frames per second, and you get a kind of semi-slow motion effect where it just makes things look more dramatic, but it's not like over the top slow motion. And if for some reason you don't want it to be slow motion, you don't slow it down, you just drag it as it is on a 24 frames per second timeline, and it's going to output as a 24 frames per second clip. I put up a prompt for questions on my Instagram stories a while ago, and here are some of those questions. Salty Butter says, how long have you been doing photography for? Again, tough question. About 8 years ago, I might have picked up a camera. I was borrowing it from friends. It was really fun. I was just using it for fun, helping people out, and got the hang of it until I got my own camera. No, wait, before that, I was working it with an NGO and they had their camera, but I was the only one who knew how to use it. So I was constantly using it to help out with their projects until I got mine. I did my first wedding. I did my first commercial event, networking, blah, blah, blah. And about the last 2 or 3 years, I've been doing it a lot more frequently and professionally. Solitude says, how have you gained so many followers? That's very relative. I don't think I have so many followers because I have almost 6,000 now on Instagram, which is nothing compared to someone with, I don't know, 6 million. But the answer, you've heard it all before, is just consistency, activity, high quality, constant interaction with people who come to your content and comment on it. And which is very important, which I think some people miss out, is outreach. You don't just sit around and wait for people to come in and hope people discover your channel. You have to get your stuff out there. So aside from like using good hashtags to be visible on more pages, you also tag feature pages, which collect people's content to feature on their pages, and not just tag them, you also send a message to them, because that gets their attention on it a lot more than the hundreds of other pictures that are being tagged with them. And of course, reach out to people who consume and generate content similar to you and be like, hey, I do this and this and this, if you're interested, come follow. Now make sure this is not spam, be like, hey, you want to sub for sub, you want to follow for follow, or come check out my account. It's just be nice, interact, be interested, and it would really help you if you engage with their comments. Say, hey dude, this is nice, this is cool video, cool lighting, cool whatever, you know, I make stuff like this too, and maybe that'll spark interest and make them come to your account, and you haven't forced them there, so you're gonna make a genuine follower out of them. Light Without Heat says, what is your favorite Lightroom / Photoshop feature? Now in Photoshop I use blending modes a lot. This is like super basic because everyone uses it, but I think blending modes are really cool. All of them, like I've used each one of them at one point, okay, maybe not each one of them, at one point or another, and they're super useful. And I don't know how I'd be making half of my photography without the overlay layers in Photoshop. And another function I discovered like recently after doing Photoshop for years and years, just this year I discovered the blend diff function, and that is a very powerful tool and I like it. These are some DMs on Instagram that people have been sending me. So Solitude says, reacts to one of my stories, he says, you ride? Yeah, I ride. I would come for a weekly lesson for a year and a half or so, and I gotten decent at riding. I never got any exams. I didn't want to do the dressage exams. I just ride for my own fun, but lately I haven't had the time to. So while I do ride, it happens pretty rarely. Okay, this one's a long one. Dante Piatis says, bro, I love your videos. Thank you. Just well done. Do you take any Padawans or new friends at the moment? Because I might have a few questions or a talk or whatever similar to that. Yes, I love teaching. I love spreading information. I am short on time. So if everyone is gonna all of a sudden crowd me with like requests for tutorials or Skype conversations asking them to teach them, it's not gonna happen. But I am very willing to teach people, to answer any questions and stuff like that. Anyway, thanks for making videos and being born, for starters. My honor. I totally am responsible for being born. Hope we can talk or meet sometime soon. Yeah, bro, you're cool. I hope so too. Photo Brian says, hey, as you know, I'm still an up and coming photographer. Would you be willing to maybe help me out by maybe giving a shout out for a shout out? Now this is last question, and I left it for the end for a reason, because I have an important message. Tons of people have been asking me this and I keep typing the same thing, but I decided to make it in video format. I am really open to any and all kind of collaborations. It doesn't matter on the size of a creator. You might be an awesome photographer with no followers and we can make awesome content together and feature each other. I am completely and totally for it, because we offer value to each other in terms of skill. And even if we're doing an online collaborations, I take a photo or video and you edit, or you take a photo or video and I edit, or you feature me in your Q&A and I feature you in my Q&A, and that is exchanging of values. But a shout out for a shout out, especially from someone who is way, way, way smaller than you, that's the same as saying, hey dude, can you just shout me out? If you want me to give you some kind of value, you have to offer some kind of value to me too. So it's not just, let me shout you out to my 100 followers. There has to be some kind of balance. So here, let me give you a couple of ideas. Take one of my tutorials, follow them, make a photo based on a tutorial, and send it to me and say, hey dude, look, I made this based on your tutorial, and I'm gonna shout it out that very same second. I'm gonna make a story and say, look, this guy followed my tutorial, he made these photos, props to him, amazing work. Why? That provides value to me because it's the fruit of my own educational content. Or maybe you're a painter, take one of my photographs, paint it. You're generating content for yourself, but you're also creating value for me, because I'm like, hey, look, other artists are using my work for their work. You understand the concept? I'm not trying to make myself all big like a puffed up balloon and say, hey guys, I have 6,000 followers. That doesn't mean anything. But in any kind of collaboration, any kind of request, and all artists should know this, if you want someone to give you value, you have to offer value. You might not have the same thing that they have, but you can find a way to offer something valuable to them. Be creative about it. I mean, we are creatives after all. So if you want a free shout out, then keep asking questions like this across my social media, because that prompts me to create. So your motivation, your inspiration, that's value in itself, and that is the way you're gonna get another shout out. I know this video is kind of different from the rest, maybe a little bit weird for some of you guys, but I hope it still provided some educational or at least entertainment value. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Thank you for watching, and as always, I'm gonna see you guys next week.